Chris Maylett for BBTV. We're over at the finest boxing gym here in Ancoats, and I'm with Steve Maylett, head trainer here. Steve, how's it going? You all right?
Good, yeah. Up here, yeah. Good. Yeah.
Well, passing by, I thought I'd bob in to see you, and it's turned out all right, because you're just getting ready to do a session.
Yeah, I'm going to do a session with one of the amateurs they help out, so he's got a fight coming up in 2.5 weeks, so he comes in every now and again, bit of pub work, bit of sharpening up, but yeah, he's doing well.
Is Terry in today, training?
He'd been in this morning, and we've done a hard swim session this morning, so he beat his times that he beat last week, so I'm happy.
Yeah. Well, what we need to catch up on is the news that you've recently signed with MTK, and I think you've already said Terry's moving down to lightweight again, and he's, you know, since he's defeating that Super Series thing, World Super Series, he's going to move back down, and, you know, new campaign at lightweight, and you've this news that you signed with MTK.
Yeah.
Tell us about that.
Yeah, I've done a few interviews now, and to be honest, he was offering us the best options, really. We was given some interest from other sort of promoters and stuff, but they want like a plan involved with it. It was just like a one fight deal, and then we'll see what happens from there. And they wanted him to come straight in at lightweight, which would have been stupid, really, with him not making lightweight for 2.5-3 years. Didn't want to just, he'll make the weight, but it's how you feel, it's how you perform at it. So with the 3 fights, we're going to come down in stages. We'll like make under 10 stone for the next one, then maybe 9-11, and then we'll make the 9-9 before Christmas and see how he feels at that. But the idea is to get 3 wins before Christmas, and then get ranked again in the lightweight rankings in the new year, and then we'll fight whoever again.
Mm. Obviously, Terry's been signed with Frank Warren for the, you know, the last part of his career, and you've with Steve Wood, who he was with from day one. I must say, I was pretty shocked myself that he wasn't going to be staying with Steve, and watched the interview with him recently, and he said he was shocked as well. You know, what was the thinking behind that? I know that you're a loyal and
yeah,
you've been with Steve from the beginning, but how did that come about, and what was the...
Well, Steve, the contract ran out with Frank Warren in February, and we sort of agreed between us that we was going to look no elsewhere. Frank wished us good luck, and like without Frank Warren, Terry Flanagan wouldn't have been world champion. He pushed us in the right direction, and he helped his career tenfold. With Steve Wood, he had the job of then going and getting Terry a new promotional deal somewhere. I ended up speaking to MTK just through through Tom Starker. They come back to offered us a deal. As soon as he offered us a deal, I sat down with Steve and said what we'd been offered, and we gave him the option to stay on board, but he chose not to do. We was a bit disappointed that he didn't want to stay on board with us, but he said, look, you just look like it's a major decision, and that's what you want to do, so if you want to go with him, go with him. So I don't want to fall out with him again. Steve's been good for Terry, put him on the small hall shows, brought him up with between us all. We've created a path for Terry to become world champion. So, like I said, I don't really want to fall out with him, but he didn't look too happy the other day on the interview. That's his opinion. We've got our opinion of how it happened. So,
so you happy to still stay working with Steve? Could that have worked still as manager?
I understand what Steve said. He said, like, if you're signing with MTK, like, they're going to be doing the work. They're going to be the ones pushing Terry. And if I stay on board, then I won't really be doing anything. So I respect him for saying that, but I still felt he could have played a part in it. He knows he's got a lot of contacts with opponents and stuff. He could still liaise with MTK. They said they was happy for whoever to work with anybody. They said they're happy to work with anybody. So like I say, he chose not to do. We wanted him to stay on board, but boxing's boxing and it moves on. Terry's now in probably maybe the final deal of his career, signed with MTK. We feel like we're with the best management team in the world currently. So for somebody who's going to be pushing on in the latter stages of his career, and somebody who wants to be world champion again, I think we're with the right team. Mm.
What is the plans going forward, and how, what was the meeting like with MTK? What did they offer you that persuaded you to that was the right decision to make?
Well, when I spoke to Steve, I did say I think Terry needs like a comeback fight. I mean, he's had a lot of hard I wouldn't say a lot of hard fights, but he's had a lot of high pressure fights at world level. His last couple of fights have been hard, difficult fights. I didn't want to throw him straight into another 50-50 fight. So we wanted to sort of work our way back to lightweight and back up the rankings again. So when I spoke to MTK, like I say before, they said what they thought Terry needed before I'd even had chance to say what I thought he needed, and it was exactly the same as what I was thinking. So it had been, like I say, it had been stupid to say, right, hold on, can we go and see if we can get something somewhere else. I mean, I think it's his perfect way back. He can box regular, which he needs. He can box, like I say, in Liverpool. They've said they can box in Ireland, which he's always wanted to do. He said, we'll put you a show on in Manchester. So for me, we wanted to be part of a team, not somebody just using Terry to keep throwing with their own fighters and 50-50 fights all the time. So, like I say, we've got the backing of MTK.
And you've got a plan going forward.
Yeah, that's what it was about, the plan, yeah.
What is that plan?
The plan is to make the next fight under 10 stone, still somebody with a winning record, and then probably box, say, October, one before Christmas. So we'll get the three fights in, try and make the lightweight division on the last fight before Christmas, and then see what boxing organisations put us in, their rankings. So that's what I want to see. He might go back in high in the lightweight WBO rankings, might get ranked with the WBA, whoever, and then we'll sit down again with MTK and the team after Christmas and see which path we want to take back to world level.
So these three fights coming up, I mean, Terry's, you know, world class fighters up there, it's probably matchmaking is it a difficult
it
job?
It will be difficult,
will
yeah.
Will there be non-title fights, or will there be domestic
There won't be title fights. I mean, if one did come available, like I say, if something comes up, MTK said, look, we're happy to go and work with any promoters in the world. If he gets offered a fight and they think it's winnable and the money's right and we think it's winnable, then we'll do it. But no, the idea is to get the three fights in. Whether the title fights or not don't really matter to us. I don't think they will be. But the idea is to get him back active, fighting regular. Then we'll go back into the world rankings and, like I say, we'll fight anyone from there.
Get his body prepared again, that back down at lightweight and do it correctly.
Like I said the other day, he's only 29. He's not had loads of hard fights. Like I said, the last couple have been difficult, but he's boxed at a high level for a long time. We might end up going back to 10 stone. An opportunity could come up to that, but we feel like the best route back to a world title is at lightweight.
Yeah. How is Terry? How's he looking back training?
Yeah, he's looking good. We've changed training up a little bit. We're working on like one session, but high intensity. As you know, Terry yourself, every time I bring him in, if I say, right, it's just a light session today, somehow it'll turn into an 100% session all the time. So I'm just bringing him in like once a day, every now and again, twice a day. So we changed that up and he seems to be feeling a lot better. He's saying his body feels good. When he's coming in, he's performing really well in all the sessions. So like I say, sometimes if you're giving two sessions a day, it'll only last for a certain amount of time and you'll start seeing him getting a little bit jaded because he don't know how to take it easier.
How was it working, you know, training for a super lightweight fight to make that limit? Then, you know, prior to that, obviously, that lightweight, I mean, he's moved up in the weights, he's got bigger as he's got older, so he started as something like a bantamweight, didn't he?
Yeah, he was a late developer, so some people, they will move up the weights if they're slower to develop, but he made the 10 stone easier because he was on a lot of food. When we was out in New Orleans, he made it really well, and he thought he was going to feel a massive difference on the night. Don't get lightweights, a lot harder to make, so he'll struggle from 3, sometimes 4 weeks out before the fight. But he said, actually, on the night, once he's put the weight back on and stuff, there wasn't much difference. He thought at 10 stone, he'd get in there and just feel like he's never felt before. But he said no, he said he still thinks he can make lightweight and perform well on it. He still feels like he did at 10 stone, yeah. But he will struggle in camp a little bit. Maybe his training will drop off a little bit. His sparring won't be as good. But like I say, it's up to me to work around that.
And you're happy that he wants to fight at lightweight again, and he, you know, you think that's where he's stronger at as well in that division?
Yeah, I mean, he's still got the skills. Like I say, he was unlucky in the Hooker fight. If he would have, the scorecard would have been one round different. It would have been a draw. So he was unlucky in that fight. Progress is a good fighter. Thought Terry boxed really well for 6 rounds with him. Thought it was even up until that point. Progress stepped it up a bit and caught Terry with a good shot. That changed the fight eventually. But Progress is
the first six rounds.
Like,
and he didn't
say,
look small, did he? He didn't really look.
It didn't look small, but Progress on the night when the shots landed, you could hear Progress does it. He is an hard puncher, but I think Terry caught him a couple of times and gained his respect. And when Terry made him miss early on and countered him, I think Progress had to change his tactics up a bit. So credit to him for doing that. He's a good fighter.
Yeah, absolutely. And there's some massive fights at lightweight, isn't there? And there's some fights that, you know, never got made. I mean, even the Anthony Crowler fight could be a possibility down the line at lightweight. You never know, do you?
No, we've always wanted that fight. And like I say, for, I think, a bit of boxing politics and maybe, I don't know, Terry being a bit awkward in a southpaw, maybe they never fancied the fight. But if Crowler wanted to go out in Manchester on like one of his last big fights here, I'm not sure how many fights he's got left, Anthony at the minute, or whether he will box again, but we'd love the fight, like I say, at the MEN. It would have been great for him to fight when he was both world champions, but you don't know in 6 months, 9 months in boxing, maybe one of them will have a world title again.
Yeah. You never know. Yeah, there's some good fights out there.
Yeah, no, world level, there's loads of fights. Like I say, with the divisions being tight, from super feather to lightweight and lightweight to the 10 stone, you get a lot of boxers moving up and down through the weights. So, like I say, there's loads of big names that were there in the new year, and we'll be back in big fights again.
Just saying there, what about Joshua's fight at the weekend, getting beat by Ruiz? Shock.
Massive shock to me, yeah. I didn't think it'd stand a chance, to be honest, but shows you that's why boxing's one of the best sports in the world. Everyone loves the underdog, and just when you think there's no chance for anybody, he comes up with probably the biggest upset for what, the last 15, maybe 20 years.
And Ruiz giving looks like me
confidence. Yeah, I mean, I knew he still had fast hands and stuff. I just didn't think the height and reach, I thought he wouldn't be able to land the shots, but I knew like he did have some good attributes. He's got fast hands, got good chin, he can take a shot, got good work rate, but I just thought Joshua will just keep him on the end of his jab and he's 1-2 all night. But like I say, it's good for boxing, it's not great for British boxing, but it's good for boxing on the world stage.
Have you heard the rumours that he got knocked out in sparring and he had a bit of a panic attack in the changing rooms before the ring walk? I don't know if you've heard that, and his dad wanted to call the fight off. So there was definitely something wasn't right when he walked to the ring. And
yeah, I mean, the rumours, there'll be some truth in them, and then there'll be some that are just nonsense as well. I mean, Anthony Joshua and his team and Eddie Hearn, they'll know what's gone wrong and what they should have done differently. But like I say, boxing's boxing. Sometimes you can't pull out of them big fights, no matter what has happened in the build-up. Some people have the worst camp ever, and they'll go in and give the best performance they've ever done. So, like I say, boxing's boxing. They know what's gone wrong, and I'm sure they'll correct it. They're one of the biggest and best teams in the world.
I'm sure you want an idea like Baby Miller pulled out, and
it seems to have been in New York
for a long time as well, don't they?
They'll sit down and probably feel like it was never meant to be. It was always meant to be something could go wrong, but they'll come back. It's too good not to.
Sure. Rematch apparently by the end of the year. Well,
yeah,
looks like it's going to get fragmented again, this heavyweight title. You know, if some of the other governing bodies don't agree to that rematch, it'll get split up.
And I think they've got to give him the rematch. I think
all the governing bodies.
I hope so. Yeah. I think one. I think he deserves it. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
He's carried the torch for a long time. And I'd love him to get the rematch and beat him, but we'll see what happens.
The heavyweight division, eh, is another technical twist.
Yeah,
it's interesting, isn't it?
Yeah. Like I say, with the Wilder and Fury one, that was one of the maddest fights you've seen, for Fury to get up like that. And then it ended up being a draw. But yeah, heavyweight boxing is big because of the big three, so maybe four big names at world level.
Well, Steve, we're all looking forward to seeing Terry back, you know, and back at lightweight will be interesting.
Yeah, well,
everything's going well other than that in the gym.
I've got
lads going through there.
Liam Taylor,
British title. Yes,
yeah, and hopefully that'll be September. Not been given a date or venue yet, but that's when it'll be looking like. I've got Jack Rafferty, he's up and coming. So Jake Bulger's thinking about making a comeback. So if Jake gets his weight off, then I'm sure he'll be back in the ring before Christmas.
He's fit enough, Jake, though, isn't he? I mean, when we went to that, doing them sessions at the field, he was keeping up with everyone, wasn't he?
No, you can't fault him for the work he's put in. It's just because he had that year off, obviously. He's been enjoying himself and he's put a bit of weight on, but the weight's coming back down. He's been sparring with Terry, so yeah, they can't be too far away, can they?
Any news on Dale Coyne?
No, he come to watch Liam and Jack on the last fight, so it was nice for him to come and do that. They only spoke to him once or twice, you know, since he stopped boxing, but no, he's a great lad and he was a very, very, very good fighter. So no, I don't think he'll be making a return.
He's just not been in the gym.
He's working at the minute. So he said he wanted to come in and do a bit of training, and he said he's turned up a couple of times and I've already gone or left. But no, he's a great kid, and like I say, he was exceptional. Some of the stuff he was doing in the gym, but sometimes it's just not meant to be. I don't know, he maybe fell out of love a little bit with boxing or what it was, but he's gone and got a job and he said he's happy, and that's the most important thing.
So he's grafting him. Shame that he was a good prospect.
Very good.
Well, Steve, it's good to speak to you. We'll come back in the gym when Teddy's in camp and have a catch up with him as well and everybody.
Yeah,
good to speak to you.
Yeah, cheers, right, Chris.
See you later.